Hello all, it is your good friend Dr. Alsup, and I am very excited to discuss with you the muscles of the anterior compartment of the leg. So the learning objective is full of many of our typical players here. We will be naming the muscles, talking about actions, innervation, and of course, any clinical considerations. Okay, so while we call this the anterior compartment of the leg, it is actually oriented, and the muscles are at least, oriented anterolaterally and very close to the aptly named lateral compartments. So fibularis longus is a portion of the lateral compartment, as well as fibularis brevis. So you can see that you can truly see and feel the tibia for much of the anterior medial portion of the leg, and then the muscles of the anterior compartment are located in this general region here. So anterolaterally. There are four muscles in this compartment, but we are only having you identify two of them, which happen to be the more superficial and easier to locate. The tibialis anterior is going to be the most medial within this compartment, as well as the most superficial. The extensor digitorum longus, which I'm just going to put an E right here, is going to be right next to the TA, or tibialis anterior, and when I say just next to, it's just lateral to the tibialis anterior. And these are the two main muscles you can see from a more superficial view. The EDL, similar to what we had in the forearm, will have four long tendons that will extend to digits 2 through 5, and you can see you can see the extensor digitorum longus belly here, and you can see it extending to the tendons. Deeper in this compartment will also be the extensor hallucis longus, which will be similar to the extensor digitorum longus, but specifically heading to the first digit or the big toe. Additionally, there will be a small fibularis tertius muscle that kind of looks like a little slip of muscle associated with the extensor digitorum longus. Not a particularly powerful muscle or even a very high yield muscle, so we won't have you identify that one either. But I did want you to at least have heard these names before. These muscles in the anterior compartment will affect joints in the ankle as well as the foot, with the primary action, in which all muscles in this compartment play some role, being dorsiflexion of the ankle joint or the talocrural joint. I always think of dorsiflexion as really digging in your heels into the ground and then starting to point the toes up or elevating the forefoot. While again, all of these muscles will play a role in dorsiflexion, it's the tibialis anterior, or TA, that has the most mechanical advantage in making it the strongest or primary mover in terms of dorsiflexion. Tibialis anterior will also cross the subtalar and transverse tarsal joints to attach to the medial border of the foot, which makes this muscle capable of inverting the foot, working with the tibialis posterior muscle, which is located in the posterior leg. So I always think of inversion as moving the sole of the foot or the plantar surface more medially, whereas the opposite motion, eversion, is moving the sole of the foot more laterally. There is a greater range, so try to do inversion and eversion on your own foot, and you'll find that the greater range of motion is going to be an inversion rather than eversion. An easy way to remember which muscles do what is that tibialis muscles will invert, whereas fibularis muscles, so if it has tibialis in the name, such as tibialis anterior, it will invert the foot. Or if it has fibularis in the name of the muscle, it will evert the foot. And yes, we just discussed that fibularis tertius is in this compartment. And yes, it will play a slight role in eversion, but it is relatively weak, so we didn't put it here with this compartment. It will be a much bigger deal. Eversion will be a much bigger deal in the lateral compartment. Lastly, we had all of those long tendons from the extensor digitorum longus and hallucis longus, and these will cause extension of the digits or straightening from a flex position. The muscles of the anterior compartment are innervated by the deep fibular or deep peroneal nerve, which is one of the two terminal branches of the common fibular or peroneal nerve. Damage or a lesion to the deep fibular nerve may lead to a complete inability to dorsiflex the ankle, as in the toes are, as in the foot kind of has this appearance of being too long. The toes do not clear the ground during the swing phase of walking if you cannot dorsiflex your ankle. And this could be due to just a direct injury to the deep fibular or peroneal, or it could be due to an injury to the common fibular or peroneal as well. That common fibula wraps around the neck of the fibula in a fairly subcutaneous position, leaving it vulnerable to direct trauma. So an injury to the common fibular peroneal would affect the deep fibular as well as the superfibular, which innervate the anterior and lateral compartments respectively. Lastly, let's discuss a few additional clinical considerations in this area. We discussed compartment syndrome back in our first session of MSK, by which increased volume in a compartment caused by all kinds of different things. It could be infection, it could be a hematoma, just a variety of issues could cause this. That is not able to move out of that compartment due to a relatively unyielding deep fascia, and that can lead to increased compartmental pressure. This is compartment syndrome. And the anterior compartment of the leg is typically named as the most common compartment for which this occurs. So this is a common thing that I hope you understand the connection between the two. Additionally, this compartment is commonly considered with shin splints, or sometimes called tibialis anterior strain. Shin splints typically present as pain and or edema in the area of the distal two-thirds of the anterior leg, which is often caused by repetitive microtrauma to the tibialis anterior, so little micro tears associated with the muscle, or even minor tears of the periosteum, or that connective tissue that's surrounding the neighboring tibia. So when you think shin splints, I want you to think anterior compartment of the leg. Excellent. Thank you for joining me on this journey of the muscles of the anterior compartment of the leg. Please take time to review and reach out with any questions. Thank you for your time and attention, and have a great rest of your day.